angry history, land upon the glory of Britannia and not history. Erase his propaganda from a particular time and we can easily move on from it. And the fact that it's controversial tells us a lot about the version of Britishness we're seeing, which is we can't have a proper accounting of history. We can't be critical of Britain. We can't say, actually, there's something we just need to move on from. And if we can't do any of those things, then we're never going to get to the proper discussion. So it does matter. And it does worry me that we're stuck here still.
Well, both of you, thanks for joining us this morning. The debate, I'm sure, will continue. Thanks for joining me, and Kehinde, on the controversial subject matter of whether Land of Hope and Glory in Britannia should no longer exist. And I know the BBC are considering it, aren't they?
Yeah, it's going to be a very different one this year anyway, isn't it? Because obviously you haven't got the audience singing along in the same way that they would do, and that those ones in particular have a lot of audience participation, don't they? And as you were mentioning, they won't be able to get full orchestras in because of the restrictions,
that's
so some of them they might not be able to play
reasons being cited at
because of technical issues anyway. But interestingly, you've been getting in touch this morning. We were asking you, should we ban these songs from last night of the proms? And those of you getting in touch are saying no. Rob on Facebook says these